capitán del barco ballenero Pequod. En un viaje anterior, la ballena blanca Moby Dick mordió la pierna de Ahab cuando se estaba muriendo por la pérdida de sangre.
The captain of the whaling ship Pequod on various previous voyage, the white whale Moby Dick bit off Ahab's leg. When he was dying from blood loss, he was approached by a woman who promised to give him a chance at revenge, which he accepted. He now wears a prosthetic leg made out of whalebone. The whaling voyage to Pequod ends up as a hunt for revenge on the whale, as Ahab forces the crew members to support his fanatical mission. When Moby Dick is finally sighted, Ahab gets his revenge on the whale. His mania and hunt for revenge doesn't end there, but continues on a one-man mission against all aquatic life. Born April 7th, Ahab was named by his insane widowed mother, who died when he was 12 months old. At 18 years old, Ahab bursted to sea as a boy-harpooner. Less than 3 voyages ago, Ahab married a sweet, resigned girl with whom he has a young son. He has been in colleges and among the cannibals, and has seen deeper wonders than the waves. He has fixed his alliance, the keenest and surest on the isle of Nantucket, and stranger foes than whales. Years ago, Peleg, now the co-owner of the Pequod, sailed as mate under Ahab during the voyage. A typhoon near Japan swung her 3 masts abroad, overboard. Every moment, the crew thought the ship would sink, the sea breaking over the ship, but instead the company of death, Captain Ahab and Peleg somehow saved all hands on the rig, jury rig masts, in order to get into the nearest port. Ahab long ago lay for dead for 3 days and 3 nights off Typhoon. Was involved in a deadly scrimmage with the Spaniard afore the altar in Santa, and spat into the silver communion cup. Last voyage, a whale, the monstrous parmacetty, had ever shipped off a boat, bit off Ahab's leg, and the pains in his stump made him never jolly, desperate moody. Adding insult to injury, Ahab is one day, when sailing from England and gave a ride from Native American girl Rebecca back to the Colonies, Ahab is 58 years old at the time of his revenge. Peleg and Bildad piled the ship out of the harbor, and Ahab first appears on deck. When the ship is already at sea, instead of embarking on a regular whaling voyage, Ahab declares he is out for revenge and lowers the doubloon on the mast by way of revenge for the crew member who first sighted Moby Dick, the white whale. Peleg refers to Ahab respectfully as a grand and godly, godlike man, but he is also nicknamed Old Thunder. Ahab is thousands of fish and dozens of sharks and several octopuses and squid was stronger than 100 whales, could swim at speeds faster than 7,000 miles per hour, and he could breathe underwater, see in the dark, and summon harpoons magically and throw them with incredible speed and force and precision. As he continued on his quest to end all aquatic life, he was eventually confronted by a leviathan. The beast bore him under the waves with a tentacle, but learned about Ahab's powers. Ismael, Peleg, and Bildad waited as long as they could before returning home without him. Ahab was never seen again. Ishmael feared this leviathan must be the most legendary creature in the world to defeat Ahab.